We have two more examples that we want to take a look at, and these last two examples are going to be just a little bit different than what we've considered so far. And that main difference being that, for instance, with this graph, we have these two vertical asymptotes. So we're going to get to some slightly different cases to consider, but we're still basically going to apply the same approach. Look at the left-hand limit, look at the right-hand limit, and see whether or not those results agree with each other. So we're going to start with considering the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the right-hand side. So we still start with this idea of starting at positive infinity, tracing along our function, and see what's happening to our function as we get closer and closer and closer to this value of negative 2. So since we have an asymptote here, our function value is just going to continue plummeting down, lower and lower and lower, without ever crossing that line. So in this case, we've got a graph that as we approach from the right is headed to negative infinity, because our function value is just going to keep getting smaller and smaller and smaller. If we consider the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the left, so again, same idea. We're starting from negative infinity, working our way up, and then tracing along this graph as we get closer and closer and closer to x equals negative 2. What's going to happen is our function value is going to keep increasing, getting larger and larger and larger without ever actually crossing this line, x equals negative 2. So in this case, our function value is headed to positive infinity. So far we've had these results always come up as numbers. Also possible to have these come up as infinity or negative infinity if we're dealing with an asymptote. And then we consider the limit as x approaches negative 2. So our right-hand limit is negative infinity, left-hand limit is positive infinity. Since those are different from each other, what we say is the limit as x approaches negative 2 doesn't exist. So now we'll consider the limit as x approaches 1 from the right-hand side. So in this case, again, we have a function that's getting closer and closer to this vertical asymptote. That function value is going to continue increasing without bound. So that limit is headed to positive infinity. But if we consider the limit as x approaches 1 from the left-hand side, we're approaching this specific function value, so not an infinity. We're approaching this function value of negative 1. So in this case, the limit as x approaches 1 of f of x does not exist, because again, our left and right hand limits are different from each other. So we also have a new case to consider in part C here. We want to consider the limit as x goes to infinity. A little bit different than the cases we've considered so far. So we want to think about starting from x equals 0 and tracing along our graph as our x value just keeps getting larger and larger and larger and larger. So what we can see is that our function value kind of decreases and then sort of keeps getting closer and closer and closer to what's not marked, but what's actually a horizontal asymptote. So our function is going to keep getting closer and closer and closer to this line y equals negative 3 without ever crossing it. So the limit as x goes to infinity is going to be negative 3. What I don't already have written on here, but we can also consider, is what's happening as x approaches negative infinity. So again, think about starting at 0, 0, and just considering values as x gets smaller and smaller. So tracing along this graph, this function value is just going to keep increasing without bound. So as x approaches negative infinity, our function value is approaching positive infinity. So again, we have a couple new cases here. We get limits that can equal positive or negative infinity, or we can consider limits as x goes to positive or negative infinity. But for now, what we're doing is just keeping that same approach. Read off the graph what's happening, around those values, and then consider both the left and right hand limits and apply that to coming up with an expression for the limit itself. So we'll take a look at one more example like this. We'll consider the limit as x approaches 2. And again, we'll do that from both the left and right hand sides. So at x equals 2, as we approach from the right hand side, our graph is plummeting down to negative infinity. As we approach from the left hand side, we're shooting up to positive infinity. So we get negative infinity, positive infinity. And again, since those values are different from each other, we say the limit of the function as x approaches 2 does not exist. We can consider the limit as x approaches 4 from the right-hand side, the limit as x approaches 4 from the left-hand side. So at x equals 4, we see as we approach from the right, our function is plummeting down to negative infinity. As we approach from the left, same thing's happening. So in this case, both of those limits will be negative infinity, which means our limit as x approaches 4 of f of x is going to be, since those two limits are equal, negative infinity. Then we can consider the limit as x approaches infinity. So this is again the case where we think about starting at 0, 0, and look at what's happening as x just gets larger and larger and larger. So again, in this case, we're getting closer and closer to this value of y equals 0. So we've got a horizontal asymptote, and that limit is going to be 0. And if we considered the limit as x approaches negative infinity of f of x, we get the same thing happening on the other end of the graph. As our function values, as our value for x is getting smaller and smaller and smaller, our function is getting closer and closer to this line y equals 0 without ever crossing it. So that limit would also be 0.